Hi everyone, it's 5 p.m. for me. We should start, you should be able to hear me. Welcome everyone on the functional group update of the CI/CD team. You can find the presentation link in the invitation. There is also, if you are interested what we talked about the last time, you can click this link in this presentation to the previous one. But let's start with the current release. So the accomplishments. This is like the very important thing because the last release was pretty tough. We all had like amazing summit when we had an opportunity to meet each other and spend time together and have a really fun time. But it also it's like very hard time to deliver things that we planned. We actually, as part of 10.2. We closed more issues than we had in 10.1, so it is basically impressive that we managed to do basically more. But we also did take big undertaking on Kubernetes story and GK integration because we quickly figure out that the architecture that we ship in 10.1 for GKE and Kubernetes was not really the best one that we could like envision for the future scalability of the feature. So we decided that we want to change that. We want to change that quickly, iterate quickly, improve that, and be done with that. But it turned out to be like very big task that like everything else from the Kubernetes story that kind of depend on. But we did manage to do it in just time. It's like we merged everything like most of our merge because in the last 2 days, it was crazy, right? But we managed, we are done with that, we can iterate on top of that. And it was like very impressive from everyone in the team, how they work together on getting this done, helping each other on solving the issues, fixing tests and making sure that we can merge that in time. But this is not the only thing, there are also things that we've been working on and things that we are continuing working on. For example, today we merge GitLab triage gem to GitLab runner. Alessio can probably update on chat when it's gonna be executed. So we'll be more aggressive on closing GitLab runner issues if there is no response in the time. Because right now the GitLab runner issue tracker is growing and we need a better way to control amount of the information stored there. But this for more about the accomplishment about some engineering side, but there are also actually accomplishment about the team itself and the way how we present ourselves and talk about things. So Mattia, he's this guy actually that like did this undertaking on making Web ID on the summit. So we invited Mattia to start helping us with the CI/CD deliverables. And Mattia so far is doing really great on trying to help us with Kubernetes direction deliverable of this release. Also, we got back to having the CI/CD team retrospective every month. We will continue having that. We'll probably have that somewhere around 1 week before the company-wide retrospective because it allows us more easily and much better iterate on how we are performing as a team and how we could improve our teamwork. The next thing, actually, this is like, you could consider this kind of promotion and like very important thing. Alessio become the maintainer of GitLab Runner. He's like focusing most of his time on support issues, helping customers, helping our users, specifically about the GitLab Runner and everything that is connected with that part of the CI product. And this kind of actually allow us to move Tomasz to be more focused on the reliability expert. Tomasz previously was the maintainer of GitLab Runner. He became the reviewer of GitLab Runner, so he's still actively helping with everything that we work on there, but he's like full focus right now is on production readiness of the CI. But previously he was like more focused on the only runner part of the CI. Currently, his focus is basically full stack. So he covers end to end. So he covers infrastructure monitoring, security, runner, Rails communication. He also covers helping handling abuses and basically building all the tooling and filling the gaps in the product from the engineering side that would help us to better manage these kind of things. But also this is the scalability. We know how important is the CI for GitLab.com and for GitLab in general. So there has to be a person that is basically constantly dedicated for this story. And also GitLab Runner Manager on Kubernetes. This is like the big story for everyone in the company right now, switching to Kubernetes. And we also like follow this train of everyone doing that. And we also want to be ahead of the curve in this case. The last thing, we had actually UGC session during Summit about the CI scale. You could consider this be more like me complaining about the state of the CI. It's probably something like that. But if you click this link, you will find actually my preliminary notes that I actually had prepared ahead of this session, where we actually covered like 1/6 of the content. But you could actually have a glimpse of what we could also talk about the CI scale at GitLab.com in the future, but also find the links to everything that we discuss on UGC and go through these graphs, go through these materials that are listed there. As always, a lot of things goes right, but some things also goes wrong. So I did mention about this huge undertaking of this refactor. We did manage, but it kind of put a lot of pressure and a lot of communication challenge for everyone in the team. It was worth doing that, but it also did cost us a lot of like the people working on this story. This also kind of impacted the part that we are continuing this series. We wanted to conclude basically some important part of the Kubernetes integration is to move Kubernetes from service to cluster page. Basically, due to this refactoring, we decided to split this story and ship smaller iterations, smaller deliverable for 10.2, and basically postpone this work to continue and finish that in this release. It's like 90% done. We will manage that, but this is definitely a low light. Alessio, who did jump in on GitLab Runner train, actually started improving also GitLab Runner code base with some concurrency challenges that we have, because we started testing our runner with the race detector, and we detected 21 data races that we have to fix just to make sure that GitLab Runner code base is concurrent and it's good. We are still continuing working on the object storage. This is like very big task, which is like very important for all the GCP. We seem that we fixed the last outstanding bug that prevented us from migrating all artifacts to object storage. So we will basically continue on migrating the rest of the data. Then we'll be basically left with figuring out what to do with the traces and migrate traces to. And also we rented Jagos to Geo team on helping GitLab Q&A, because GitLab Q&A is like the best way to test the Geo end-to-end story. And Jagos was like the best knowledgeable person about Q&A, because he was like the first person introducing that at GitLab. So as for the 10.3, we are actually continuing some stories that we started. Probably the biggest story that we are continuing this release is adding support for multiple clusters, multiple Kubernetes clusters per project. So you could probably, like delegate one of your clusters to basically be used only for your production apps and other cluster views for the review apps. This was one of the things that was like one of key deliverables for the company-wide tasks that was announced by the seed some time ago. But we are also like helping with, actually this is done static application on security testing. This is already merged. So we are also helping with extending the CI/CD scope with adding automated SAST. This is big help from Dimitri, who is doing all the backend work, and Filipa, who she is doing the frontend one. We also working on the helping building some needed APIs for better handling crypto miners, improving performance, and also solving a lot of runner issues, and of course, continuing working on the object storage. We are working on the object storage because this is like part of the bigger undertaking of the GCP migration, which is like starting to get, we are starting to get a picture of what has to be done, and object storage is one of these like the key factors that would allow us to move from stateful application to more like the stateless 12-factor application. One of these tasks is definitely object storage. The second one is actually probably somewhere around the same size, is decoupling GitLab pages from GitLab and allowing us to easily migrate to GCP without being stopped and having to migrate GitLab pages too. But also we are working on GK integration, and we will definitely continue working. Like, if you look at the CI/CD planning, our original plan was to, and it still is to add group level clusters next release. It's still yet to decide whether this is something that we will be doing, but this is like the major candidate today for 10.4 at least. And 10.4 is also moving GKE out of beta phase to be GA phase. So making it something that we are committing to support in that specific form for longer period. Because right now we are still making a lot of changes. We are still making a lot of improvements. And this is still like not the production quality that we could like think of that. Also OKRs, and we are working hard on trying to hire more developers, seniors and intermediates. The current plan is to hire 4 more developers. So it's basically like doubling the CI/CD team capacity, which is like big undertaking in its own. CNGitLab.com. Bitcoin miners, this is like probably never ending story. This is something that we are like having the constant fight for probably like 6 months right now. For example, recently we were hit by the problem of the growing pending jobs. Definitely the same thing that we discussed on the UGC session. And in the case where Bitcoin miners can scale up like very rapidly to having like 7K, 10K, 20K pending jobs, we are having the scalability problems. This definitely has to be solved like using two approaches. One is like being more aggressive in discovering them and killing them. And the second one is like finally implementing the proper queuing for the CI jobs, something that we are discussing for a crazy amount of time, but something that is like getting more and more important with the how we grow CI at GitLab.com. Also, we actually recently had very good work on enabling end-to-end monitoring of all autoscaled machines. However, we are hitting some performance problem of the Prometheus, because as you probably know, we are creating crazy amount of the machines. In the hot times when we process a lot of builds from GitLab.org, so basically our own builds and the shared runner builds, we can process something like 2,000 jobs at single time. This is probably like our upper limit. And just because a lot of these machines are ephemeral, so we constantly create them and destroy them. So this list is like very dynamic. We are hitting actually the file descriptor limits, IO limits, and CPU limits of the Prometheus. We thought that Prometheus 2.0 would help us, And it's definitely helping us because it allows us to handle way more. But this is not yet still that actually works constantly and without any problems. This is something that is Tomasz right now working on. And we hope that with the joint effort of the Prometheus team and the CI/CD team, we could finally like enable that for everyone to see this kind of metrics. Basically, like knowing exactly how many CPUs we are using GitHub.com wide at the specific time. We are looking basically at this kind of information, but also at the information how much egress traffic we are using in like given period of time. So I mentioned about the hiring at this kind of shows a little about our hiring pipeline. This is actually the summary of these two positions, because these are two separate positions, senior and the backend. The pipeline is, let's say, like medium. It could be better. Right now we have around 14 applicants in like the assessment phase that we are like interviewing and like ping pong backing on trying to get most from them from our questionnaire. And we also have four developers in the second stage, where we are actually having the course with them, or we are actually having the second or the third call with them. So it's like trying to hit this goal of five developers. We don't have 5-11 developers in the interview phase, but it seems that we should be able to hire maybe half of that, maybe more. It just depends how good will be the applicants in the first stage. But as you probably know and aware, the hiring process is like usually like very, very long. Before we like contact with the person for the first time and this person joins GitLab, it's probably like in the best case, like 2 months. In like probably like pessimistic cases, like maybe even 3 months. So it's not very fast process, but we are still like optimistic that we could maybe hire some half of them. And basically this is all. I would probably look at the questions. Alessio did mention that we start closing a lot of issues tomorrow at 5 a.m. UTC. So we'll see how it goes and how the response will be from the community. Okay, so I'm not seeing any more questions. If you have more questions, you can ask on the CI/CD channel. So thank you very much, and see you on the team call then.